Hi guys, nice to be with you again. I'm from InnersWay.com. Here's the next gig. One of my grandson turning 6 this year, and he has another special request from me. He wants me to make a three-dimensional character cake, Emmett, from the Lego movie. So I'm gonna do that for him. It's always for me is a big pleasure, a priceless feeling, when we bring the cake into the room, I look at their faces, when I see their surpriseful expression, and then really joyful feelings on their face. It makes me really happy, and then I can do all over again tomorrow. So that's why I like to give a lot of attention to this cake, make as detailed as possible, to see their faces more joyful than ever. So I cannot see your faces, but I like to make you also happy. That's why I like to turn this one also into a tutorial that you can also have some information. Maybe you can also make your children or your grandchildren or your friends happy with that. So it will be a pleasure for me to share this information with you. It is going to be a standing three-dimensional cake. And when we're talking about standing cake, three-dimensional, etc., so we need to have a really good planning. So we need to have the dimensions, what I'm going to use inside, etc. So next thing I like to do, I'm going to share with you all those informations. I'm going to make the plan in front of you. These are all the reference pictures I print out from internet. Thanks to Google Images, you can find millions of informations over there. As I always said, but not every information is possible to make cake. So I select the right one. So this is the one I'm looking for. I'm looking for this face, this mouth, but this eyes. And I have a picture over here. I can see what's happening on the back. And I can even print the blueprint. So I will have a good idea over here. So about the proportional part of it. So I just increase the size in the photocopy machine from the right view and from the front view. I didn't need anything else here. So what I did is put this in the photocopy machine. I have this zoom effect that I decided how big is the cake. I just organized that zoom. It took me a couple of time because as I said, I joined this together. You can't make, just put it there and then exactly one size, but you can always fold the picture into the little parts and then increase the size. And then you can join after that, of course, the size that you're looking for. So I don't need these pictures at the moment. I just put it aside. And this is already done. So I have my plastic sheet, it's semi-transparent. It works always well because this is like a little bit matte, and I can also see everything that I put underneath. So this is, I will do it like this. And then that's the second one. So probably do it like that, but maybe I change it to this a minute. First addition I like to do is, where's the base? So the base is around here. About this size. And I will have internal support. It comes from here all the way up, from here. And I will just go a little bit more higher here in the middle, because I need to have some extension to join this, the head part. I guess it's about 27 centimeters. It's good. I always use a pencil, as you realize it, because I'm very, very free to do mistakes here. And then once I decide what to do, then I'm going to use my my marking pen. Okay, so this will be then internal support. It's about 27 cm. And this is my nut. And I have my legs here to gain this space that the nut doesn't touch the table. And also there's some finger space underneath so I can lift up the cake very easily. So I'm not gonna worry about all those other parts, and I just wanna do that drawing where the cake is. So this is the cake part. Okay. And what's happening here is another very important decision is, when you look at this image, then you have to decide which part is the cake, which part is the sugar. So I always prefer to make some parts out of sugar because I don't have to really go through that trouble to make every single little hands and little things that out of cake. Imagine just little piece about 2 centimeters. You have a cake inside, outside fondant. It will be very troublesome and also like it doesn't turn up realistically. So that's why I take the bigger part as a cake, so easy to finish. At the same time, the rest of the things I can make out of sugar a lot more detail and it can create a lot of wow effect. So there's a issue here. So normally I build up cakes to put the internal support. Sometimes we do it outside and then pocket inside. And sometimes we build the cake around the internal support. So this one, because the size of the here, the cake, the size of it is actually just about 5 centimeters. It's just like any other sandwich, pre-sandwich cake. So I'm gonna make this one as a lying position. And after that, I'm gonna put some hole in the middle. After that certain stage that I'm happy with the till there, then I'm gonna lift up the cake and place it place it on top of the internal support. It will stand properly. So as I imagine that I'm gonna make this cake look like this. So this is another base underneath here. I need a base like this. It doesn't matter how. I'm not gonna worry about this part. So I'm gonna make the cake just look like this. Then will be a hole in the middle like this. And I'm gonna pop this cake over here. Then I can continue with all the other details. So pretty much I know what to do now. I have my sizes. So next thing I like to tell you, what we need to finish this cake is material, tools, and ingredients, etc. To make this three-dimensional Emmet cake, we need these items what you see on the table. So starting from the base, it is 35 centimeter wooden board, 9 millimeter thickness, and I covered with blue velvet. So there's a hole in the middle that I can put my internal support, which is the 27 centimeter 10 millimeter, it's called M10, a long threaded rod. I will secure it with the two nuts on the top of the board and then at the bottom of the board. I will also use some of these slash straws to push it inside this metal bar and that the metal doesn't touch the cake to protect the cake. Just to make sure that is more secure. All right, then I have a candle here. I will probably make this the right hand of the Emmet holding that candle like this. So rolling pin for rolling this fondant parts. I have also here a flat additional board that I'm gonna build this cake in a lying position. So not is the standing position to have a bit more comfort. So I'm gonna use that piece of white mud cake, which is already pre-sandwiched. How do I get that? I have always these big slabs in my fridge. I just go there and then cut a piece what I need. So if you need to do this one yourself, I would say this is about 800 gram, what I see over here. So if you make a 600 gram white mud cake into maybe larger slab and cut in two, and inside use about 200 gram of white ganache, and then remaining white ganache probably about 300 gram. So 600 gram of white mud cake and 500 gram white ganache will do the sandwiching and masking at the same time. So I have a few pieces of knife that I have carved the cake. I can carve the cake and the palette knives, a bit of stationery here, and dusting starch fondant. So main bodies will be covered, as you see on the picture here, with orange color. And I have original softness of the fondant. So I'm gonna use that one to cover the cake. But all the rest of the colors, they're also fondant, but I add extra icing sugar inside. So somehow that if I add icing sugar inside the fondant, it will respond to my need much better because I'm gonna shape things like the arms and hands and everything. I want them to stay where I shape it, where I left it. So always good to put some icing sugar. How much? Depends of your comfort, of your speed. Between 10% to, I can go up to 20%. 20% will be quite hard. So, but you have to knead well and then do things quickly. So it is very comfortable to make it much more harder pieces that you can join to the cake very easily. So what else we have? That's all as far as I can think of, but if I forget something, I will definitely add to the comprehensive list. So if you're not in our website, please go there. You may be watching this one from YouTube. Go there, underneath the video, there is a button called material. So if you press the material, you will have a comprehensive list what we need to do this cake, including things that I forgot here. So next thing we're going to do, we're going to shape the cake. I'm going to shape the main body of the Emmet now. So I have some pre-organized templates, which I take it from this drawing. It is a plastic sheet. It's actually, I'm using often the file separator because it's plastic, I can keep them. And also I can see them, what's happening underneath, so I can draw my lines on it and cut them properly. So I cut already. I just placed this one here already, like this. It's about the same size. So it is a very geometrical shape, this one. It's not going to be a lot of problem. Just cut this one out. Like this. So from the front profile is already ready. So what I have to do now, I'm going to use my side template, which is this one. Place this one here. I'm going to use now this long knife. This is a round part, and after that, go straight. That's it. So pretty much it's ready. So what I like to do now, I'm gonna give my first coat is white ganache, and then later on I'm gonna put this in the fridge, cool down a little bit. I'm going to give it one coat of chocolate, white chocolate, so I have a nice and firm crust, so if I lift this up straight, it's not going to happen anything. So let's give it one white coat first. This will be quite rough. I'm not putting any ganache underneath. Leave it on top here. Pretty simple. Okay, then what I do, I just take my cling wrap and I cover this one with the cling wrap. So I put this in the fridge now for maybe for 10 minutes and take it out again and give it a chocolate coating. I just took my Emmet's body from the fridge and it's nice and cold now. It didn't stay too long, it's about 10 minutes. So I will remove that cling wrap now. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to give a skin of chocolate It gives a little bit more strength that when I lift up, it's gonna be nice and firm. So what I like to do first, I wanna remove that that cake from the base. Just slide your knife a little bit underneath. All right, and take it out. So it's a bit fatty here. Just put a little bit more water and I put a cellophane sheet that separates the chocolate from the base. So I put a little bit of white chocolate here. That will give a nice big thick crust behind, makes it the body much more stronger. So before that the chocolate completely hardened, immediately I'm gonna lift up and put this on top of it, right away here. That's it. Now next thing is, I'm gonna take this chocolate slowly and push it to the side. You have to do this one quickly, otherwise chocolate gets set and you will have a little bit difficulties. So once the, we cover the sides also a little bit with chocolate, this already probably like strong enough, but I'm gonna put a little bit more. Right, then I'm gonna do this on top. Just slowly. Don't have to be perfect because we're gonna cover this one more time with the ganache anyway. As I said, this is a help to make this body strong enough to stand vertical. Okay. Some here. And this round part. Already good. So chocolate is still on the body, but not really completely hardened. So I can touch a little bit to get rid of all those spikes. Good. So now, a bit of cleaning. Now, as I said to you, I'm going to put this one on this bar. I'm gonna lift up and push it in. So in order to not to create any cracks on the cake, I have to make a pre-hole first. I made already a small little hole here, but I'm just gonna go through one more time. So this is my bar and I protect it with the straw, and I just push it in here and slowly in the middle and make sure that this gap is ready to go when I'm pushing the cake on that stick. So that's already good enough. I'm gonna take this again back. Okay, that's already good enough. If I push this cake on the stick here, it's not gonna crack at all. So last thing is, I'm gonna give one more coat of ganache. I have ganache now still in very good condition. Side first. This is a pretty geometrical shape. After all, we can create all those nice corners when we do the fondant. We're just pinching on the corners nicely. Here, on top here. Good. So now I take this one. Okay, pretty much there. So next thing what I'm going to do now, I'm going to place this in the fridge for just a few moments before I put with the cling wrap on it, because I don't want to kill these corners rounded again with the just a push of cling wrap. It has to get hardened first before I put the cling wrap. So I'll do that, and then I can keep it this one so long in the fridge that till I'm ready with all the other parts. Then I may be just touching up it again once the ganache is quite cold. That will be then last touch up. So next thing what I will do now, I'm going to produce all those sugar parts, all the arms and legs and head and everything. So while this cake is standing in the fridge getting cold, and then all those parts also will get really hardened, so we can assemble easily on the next day. I will keep all the sugar pieces one day in the room temperature, get really dry. I'm going to do Emmet's parts now, and starting from hands and arms. When you see the arm part here, you see two parts. One is the yellow hand, another one is the blue arm. So it's logical decision. I like to do the hand first, because when I place the hands to the arms, hands should be a little bit more drier than the arm and can be held quite easily. So let me just do the hands first. I just grab a piece of yellow mixture and trial it first to understand how much I need. If I grab this much and do that, just flatten like this, and try it here, I think it will be just right. So that should be the right amount. Just approximately like this. This is too much. Take it to this side. That will be good. So as you see, in the middle there's a round part. I need to have something to hold in the middle, just go around of it. So instead of looking for something else exact same size, I'm going to do that stick from this pastillage mixture. Let's see. The tools has to be always nice and clean. That will be good enough. So I'm just gonna be get ready this one to just to go around of that stick to make the hands. I'm gonna do also something else now, just to have this wrist part. Is it the right thickness? Yes. That should be good enough. It has to grab the round parts, that's why I make it a little bit more roundish. So if I be a little bit quick, there will be no problem to stick everything together in the right way. So that's right. Okay, let's do the hands first. Just give a little bit of touch of fat here. Okay. That should be good. Take it out and leave it like this. So what I do, I just touch a bit of egg white here. Yeah, and then stick this one immediately. It will be held very easy. Egg white. And piece of spaghetti. Hold things in the place. Okay, next one. I think it's the same length like I did before. Do you realize this is a bit thinner? So I just want to add a little bit more. It's good. Egg white. And a piece of spaghetti, stick it here. It will hold things in place. Okay. One of the hands will hold the candle. So let's do the blue part now. Just put it aside, this one, like this. Here. Alright. Clean the table. And dry the table. And bit of fat. I'm gonna do the arms one by one. Let's do this one first.
Okay. Turn it like this. And chop it from the side. That makes it round and flat at the same time. So I want to get this one here and bend it like this. That's the way. And clean the knife and cut it off exactly the spot where we're looking for. So I like to have this arm holding like this and holding like that, have the candle. But if I put this one over here like this now, it will hold, that's fine. And I have to place this one inside that holds the right place. Bit of egg white and push it in. Glue this together and place this one in, just a small piece, so the finger is not collapsing. That's nice. So let's do the other one. Is the same thickness. Yes. So turn it like this a little bit and cut again. Okay, that's the one. So now I like to make this one, of course, the other way around. That's good. And the other hands, it will be look like also like this, like that. Okay, let's do that. A little bit of egg white here, egg white there, and piece of holder for the center. Place this in for a while. And push this one in the middle. Make sure that egg white is really contact with the other side. So that's ready to rest to dry. Okay, that's ready, and that's ready. Let's get the head done now. Clean up a little bit, and we start from the head. For the head, I want to make another small plane. So this is the blueprint that the head is quite bigger than the body. When you look at from the front side, it is coming almost in the same direction here. So when this follow up, that shoulder part follow up, it's end up at the beginning of the head side. But when I look at here, it's a little bit more less. So the head here, in this picture, a little bit smaller than this, which I like this one. So I'm gonna make another plane according to that. So I like to place this one here. Also in this drawing, there's no head part, so I like to do this one too. I'm guessing that the head has to be finished somewhere around here. So I'm gonna do it this much, just like this. I'm not going to worry about the neck part till I finish the actual body. So as you see here, the hat is bigger than the yellow part. So this has to go, this part is the, let's say this is the front, and that has to be then this part. So this thick, and it has to go in the front like this. And this one, it will have what do you call the hair part, just like this, and this one go like this and go like this around and here like that. Then this is complete round. So half a round circle, half a ball will be around that. And this one has to be a little bit more here
and a little bit more there. So that's the hat and the head has to be. And now we have also some stripes on top here, which I'm going to make later on. All right, let's follow this. Yellow first.
Well, this is a bit hard now. I'm gonna go and put this in the microwave
for just about 3-4 seconds.
Just at 3-4 seconds, 5 seconds, it turns the paste exactly what I'm looking for. So it's nice and it's not too soft, and it's nice and pliable. I can start doing things. When I look at this head, I see a cylinder. I'm sure you also see that. Is it just a cylinder? So I'm going to cut the cylinder and round this bottom part. Make sure it's just nice and smooth. That should be good. Knife is clean and dry. And one cut. Okay. As soon as this happens, I'll give a touch to the corners, so I'll make the corners a bit more roundish. Alright. It's good. So I place this one here. And give another cut. So Emmett's head is almost there. Just the cylinder one. All right. I like to give a little bit of rest to this, and then do the head. Because we're gonna do a half a bowl, so what I like to do, I do a one big bowl and cut in two pieces. But of course, I like to have one side more nicer, which I'm going to cut it from there. I think it's good. Just shape it up again a bit. So that's ready to go. So then is the lower part. I'm gonna roll it. A little bit too thick. add a bit of egg white. Place this one there and cut it accordingly. Alright, now, as you see over here, there is some stripes here, so I'm going to make cylinders, very, very thin and long, then I'm going to cut them into pieces. Prepare my knife first, as I'm going to use it later on. I need 1, 2, 3, I think it's 8 pieces, that's right. So 8 pieces, I need 4 of them. Now I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. So I like to get 2 of it, so I need to have 4 small ones. Okay. That's it. Okay, I need a bigger knife. That's 2. White again. That's one area. That's the second one. And then the crisscross 8 pieces. Just come from here, from the center, I cut. Two more, then we are finished. That's it. So Emmett's protective hat is finished, and then his head also finished. I'm gonna wait for a while and glue them together, and standing on this stand so I can nice and rest, I can do further work on it. Let's give a quick detail to the face for final touches. So I already placed my head into the holder so I don't have to disturb too much. I will hold it like this. First thing, I like to do the hair. So what I want to do, I'm gonna cut a stripe here and then see how long I need it. So if I turn this one like this around here, so it is going to somewhere this area, somewhere start here and then finishing somewhere around there. So that's okay, this one. As you see that I already prepare all those rolling parts. Brown is a little bit thicker, and all the other parts is extremely thin. I have black, white, and the red, because that the face has got black, white, and red. Okay, now the hair, looking from behind, it's a little bit less than the actual height of the head, so that should be somewhere around here. Okay, that should be the final length, and that should be the final other length. That's it. So that goes like this, and like that. Put this one here, on the other side, approximately like that. Give a little bit of detail here, as you see that one here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's nothing else on the other side, so that is, we don't need it anymore. All right, this one also don't need it. I'm gonna glue from this side, so I'm gonna put a little bit of egg white here. I'm using cotton buds because the brush is absorbing too much moisture, so I just want to make a little bit only. Okay, that is goes like this. That is good. All right. Here. Alright, I have a mouth here, black. So I already rolled the black icing very, very thin. I have a cutter, which is exactly that size according to that. So I already cut that half. And one more cut. And there, somewhere on there. Yes. Pretty good. I like to have this mud and but this ice, so I like to get two dots exactly the same size, and here and there. That's too small. That should be good. And two dots. One here and one there. I'll take this too. Now I like to press it down till I have the satisfactory size. That should be good. Now the teeth, very fine white. Somewhere on there, and then will be the tongue will be here. Alright, let's cut this one too. Very fine line, just a straight. A little bit down, so it can show the black line on the top, like this. And the tank. That's good. All done. So what we do now, we lift up this one here, put it here, and put a little bit of more egg white here. Make sure it's quite is enough to glue the rest of it. And this already done a few minutes ago. It's a bit more harder now. And place this one in here carefully at the right spot. So our head of the emmet is ready. I think pretty good. So we have to worry now other things than the head. Now it's time to coat the body of the emmet. So before I start doing that, I make some thinking. So I look at the picture and I just simulate what that's gonna happen. So when I roll the icing and when I finish all those coatings, I need to have some objects to push some indentations. So this is often we do it when we're doing in three-dimensional cakes. Sometimes we need some stitch marks, sometimes we need some lines and pushes and indentations on the cake. So we have to get all those tools in the right size, in the right shape, before we start doing those steps. Otherwise, we're just walking around and looking for things and the icing get quickly dry before we push anything and then we don't get anything nice. So I did that. When I look at this picture here, I have something to indent this area. So I have my different thickness of wood pieces. So I will use 5 millimeter thickness wood to push this area. And I will probably use something like this here and here to push it down. And I need to have this collar part in this part here. I will probably use something like this in this area. So this is also ready, just stand by. And that's not gonna be any problem. There is also something else to think about it. Which kind of method are we gonna use to coat the cake? So sometimes cakes are a bit roundish. We can just roll the icing and put it on top and then do everything what I can. Sometimes the cakes are cylindrical shaped, so I have to roll the icing in the long shape and then go around of it and maybe put another piece on top. And then sometimes, like this, it is quite geometrical. And then, good thing about this, the back of the emmet is complete flat, as you see it over here. It's complete flat. So there's little bits and pieces over here, but it doesn't matter. I can make it completely flat and then create some little maybe pushes later on if it's necessary. So that's why I'm going to coat this cake in 2 pieces. I'm going to roll the icing flat and then stick the cake on top. As you remember, the underneath is a chocolate, so I'm not going to use any kind of ganache in there. Just the water will do the job. And then after that, coat the cake on top again and then join the top and the lower part together with water and we will have, I think, a good result. So I go and get the cake now from the fridge. So it's very nice and cold, and my glad wrap is still maintained on the surface because obviously this is the next day. I did this yesterday. So in the meantime, I did all the little parts. They're all nice and dry. So we can continue now with all the comfort that we have. So I like to get this one out of this pot here first without having that problem. You see that the film still underneath, the cellophane film. So I'll keep it like this and I'm gonna roll my icing on the surface here. It will be very easy to move left and right. So this one, I like to keep it a little bit more dry. So I do some space now to roll the icing, get all the obstructions away. Surface is nice and clean and dry, and my fondant is already pre-kneaded, but I'm going to knead one more time. This side is nicer, so I will keep this one at the bottom. Here I put a little bit of starch and place that one over here. And next what I do, I take a bit of water with sponge. You can also spray it, of course. Just make the surface a bit wet. It should be sticky, but not too wet. So that's why I try to get the sugar out of the fondant, make this water more syrupy. Okay. Now, cling wrap, remove. Make sure there's nothing left. And the cake underneath is chocolate. So this is quite nice and straight. Touch a little bit and place it here. All right, now we can move this also to the side and do the next step. Okay, this is now big enough. I like to leave it a little bit more thicker. Hopefully it doesn't, no cracks appear on the side. So what I do now, I'm going to take this one this way and go on top of it. Now what I like to secure first, secure the corners. That looks quite okay to me. Okay, basically the shape is there, but still very roundish on the corners. So what I like to do now, I want to make this those corners a bit squish. So just pinch it like that. Okay, let's do this one now first. So this is the one that the belt area. That is the round part. Then comes the flat part. There's the feet. Little bit more pinchings. Now we can take our time a little bit because there will be no more major pushes on the fondant, so there will be no danger of getting more cracks or something like that. Pinching is very important. The pinching makes the corners 90 degrees with absolute corners. See that straight heavy wood helps a lot to create that corners also. So as you realize that the upper icing is actually connected with the lower one because of the water on the surface of the base. Okay, I like to now they cut the edges. So because of the connection is very nicely done with water and with these pushes of the wood, when I cut that area, those areas, I think you don't even see the join. Okay, let's try once. Yes, it looks quite good. Okay. Okay, now the last thing is that pushes here. That's in the middle. And then last thing is I like to do that collar is just in the middle here, you can see it. I just push it once here, once there. So it's already done at this stage, so we can do the further work now with this. Emmett's body already coated with the orange fondant. So as you see, I already coated with the cling wrap because I don't want to get any moisture on the cake while I'm talking and losing time at the moment. So because the cake is cold and then the moisture will make the surface wet. So at this stage, I have two directions to go. One is lift up this cake, place it on the board, and then while I'm cutting and joining all those little bits and pieces on the surface, deal with the gravity. Or I can take advantage of gravity, keep Emmett lying down, and then glue all those things on this position. I can lift up later on. I think this is the way I like to do now. So remove that cling wrap first. And the first thing I like to do, I like to do this belt. I have already pre-rolled some white, black, and blue fondant. Okay, a little bit of water here. This area. All right. Later on, I will just put three pieces of this little orange piece on top. Okay, now I have this part here. Gonna cut small piece. Just estimation. This much. Good preparation is always good when you're doing with fiddly things. So make sure your tools are around and your material is already pre-rolled. That's done. Okay, let's do this part. Now is this part. Okay, I want to put the blue part here, the shirt. So I don't know how big is the cut, so I'm just going to make some exercise here with the paper cutting. I'm guessing it's like that. Yes, pretty correct. Good, and then a small piece for the white part. Yes. Okay, I need this one here, this one there. What else? I need to have a little blue piece over here. I guess something look like this. If you give it a few minutes to the fondant, it can be held like this in the air, and then you can use a scissor to cut it. So that should be good enough. That should be around this area. Yes. What else? Okay, I have something special here. You see, I printed in the computer. This label here, that is the security card, I believe. That is, you don't have to do it, but I like to do it, so give more detail. actually, yes, a bit more detail here. That looks nice. I have some black lines here, as you realize, that here and here. So what I did, I take the black fondant and I add water into the black fondant just on the table with the little palette knife, and get this one into the consistency that I can pipe. So as you see, you can pipe this thin lines. I'm going to use this one now to get this detail done. Works pretty well. So I think we have one more thing here, just missing this one and this one. Only what's missing here, two little orange lines over here. I'm going to edit this one right after that. This will be the final stage of doing this cake. My Emmet body is ready. My board is ready. As you see, I already secured my long thread rod into the board, in the middle of the board, and with two nuts underneath one and top here. And I will also protect the cake with some slash straws. Put it here, and second one here. And I don't need more than that, so I just cut from here. Okay, that comes here. And the parts are ready, the arms, as we did yesterday. I remove this one now. This is nice and dry from other side. You see that spaghetti, egg white, and all those things works properly. This one also remove. Then I also make another piece as a neck. Now let's put this cake together. As you remember, I make a hole already underneath the cake, all the way till to the neck. So I just push again one more time. That's already nice and free. I like to make one more hole here on the neck part, so make sure that the rod coming from exactly this spot. That's okay. So that should be good enough. So let's lift up the cake now. You just slide the cake at this base here, and then lift up like this. Hold it. And hold it like this and put it in. Slowly. Make sure that the rod coming up from the spot that what we're looking for. That's good. Okay, a little bit of cleaning here. Nice. All right. Okay, it's pretty secure now. So next thing to do, we're gonna put this neck part using a little bit of white chocolate. Pretty good. Then I'm gonna put the head right here. We have already pre-hole underneath, so it's going to be no problem to secure that here. That's pretty. So I like to have one arm holding the candle, so I'm going to place it right here like this. So to do that, I like to use a little bit of help of the spaghetti pieces. So this has to give me a little bit of hold till the chocolate start setting. Like this. that. It should be look like this. I should put it on the other side, this way. This will be fine. Okay, don't need so big, just a little bit, enough. All right, I'm gonna place it like this. So just to carefully, some chocolate. I don't want the chocolate too much running out. And then in this area also. I need to hold it for a few seconds. Well done. So next one is down here, like this. I don't need any kind of spaghetti here because that's already quite secure. This area like this on the vertical situation like this is good. Okay, it's there. So I like to put the candle here first, just to put a little bit of chocolate here. I think this will be more than enough to hold it. That's it. And last thing is, I like to put the stripes at the behind. So I also, what I like to do, I also put some line over here. I think this one is good. Just to make a bit more indentation to show that actually this is look like this behind. I wanted to put, there's a two hole here underneath. I have the wooden piece over here like this, and I put a bit of cling wrap over here to make an indentation. Just to make it a bit more real from the behind. Okay. So I like to put two more lines here, just like the original one. Here and here. That's okay. White stripes. Good. So it should be one here. One here. One here and one here. Chop this ends. Okay. Last thing is to remove that plastic sheet from underneath. Even that small little piece touching to the cake, but I don't want this touching to the cloth, so that's why I like to keep that plastic sheet underneath. Okay, what do you think? I think this cake is completely finished now. So next thing, I can't wait to see my grandson's face when he sees this cake first time when I walk in the room with the cake in my hand. So I also hope this tutorial put some smiles on your faces too.
Soon you'll see me again with another video right here. Till then, stay cool, be healthy and happy. I leave you now with a couple of shots from the actual birthday party. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.